Low, by Charles Hoyfort, Part 3, Chapter 26a. Horses erect in the blizzard of frogs, and the patter of worms on umbrellas. The hum of ladybirds in England, the twang of a swarm of Americans, at Templemore, Ireland. The appearance of Cagliostro, the appearance of Professor Einstein's theories. A policeman dumps a wild man into a sack, and there is alarm upon all continents of this earth, because of a blaze in the constellation. That all are related, because all are phenomena of one organic existence, just as, upon August 26, 1883, diverse occurrences were related, because all were reactions to something in common. August 26, 1883, people in Texas excitedly discussing a supposed war in Mexico, young men in Victoria, Australia, watching a snowstorm, the first time in their lives, crowds of Chinamen hammering on gongs, staggering sailors in the vessel, off the Cape of Good Hope. I have data for thinking that, somewhere beyond this earth, and not enormously far away, there was, before these occurrences, an eruption. About August 10th of this year 1883, at various places, appeared afterglows that cannot be traced to terrestrial eruptions. Upon the 13th of August, an afterglow was reported from Indiana, and 10 days later, from California, Monthly Weather Review, 1883, page 289. Upon the 21st and 22nd, afterglows appeared in Natal, South Africa, Knowledge, Volume 5, page 418. There was no known eruption upon this earth, by which to explain these atmospheric effects, but there was a disturbance upon this earth, and the circumstances were similar to those in Italy in April 1872. The volcano Krakatoa in Java was in a state of minor activity. It was not considered alarming.